Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Marvel Future Revolution on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Marvel Future Revolution and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Marvel Future Revolution. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to get started we need to open our favorite internet browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type that URL, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We ended up right here on the internet site of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice in-depth description on the way to download and install Marvel Future Revolution on PC. We search down a little bit and mouse click on the download game on PC button. After we click on the link, we get to the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to the game Marvel Future Revolution on our PC. As you can discover here we get some pros of preferring using that emulator. So we will proceed to download the Marvel Future Revolution by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we have to do is to launch the executable file. Okay, so we have to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the system. We answered yes. I minimized the browser to view the installation software significantly better. The installation software is quite simple. It includes a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path does. We only simply click on it. And therefore we observe that we have now here the path where the emulator is going to be put in. If we prefer to change this folder we have got to click on the Browse button, and therefore we opt for another folder and set up the emulator where we choose. I will leave it where it is. Then, I click on Back. Therefore I simply click on Install. Fantastic! The installation begins and it is going to carry on along with the download of those megabytes which are visible on the screen. As you save it on your machine, it might possibly be slightly more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate might go faster or at a lower speed, based on your internet and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Now they're running very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has been launched on autopilot. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar which will fill up when it gets into the end, the emulator can be started for the first time. Indeed, the emulator was already launched, there for the first time. Before we keep going, as you can observe, it made a couple of software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be only one we are focused on. Every time we need to start Marvel Future Revolution on the PC, we twice click this app icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we perform the following step, which is actually a requirement, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we are going to simply click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is launched. Right here we have got to sign in. So now as soon as we are right here, we have to perform this next step that is imperative. So we simply click on, sign in. Presently it says, checking info. It may occasionally get blocked in, checking info, and so it isn't going to move forward. In this case, you could try to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may very likely be fixed. At this time we will insert our email address and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example, you could use the exact same email you're using currently in your YouTube account. Then I am going to enter my details and I will come back when I have accomplished it. Voila! Details inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and providing us their twos. We are going to consent to them all by hitting, I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might let it select it, it's going to create a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched automatically and on autopilot. To set up the app, we have got to go to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon designated green colored. At present that we are watching the desktop of this emulator for Android, we observe that we come with right here the install game option. We then click on the button. Listed here we get the video game. How about we simply click right here on the install link that I'm showing now in green color. That click will begin the setup. Right now it should install the game, it could take quite some time or it might possibly be very quick. It again all varies on our own internet connection. This has actually finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular option that I'm showing in green, that allows you to launch Marvel Future Revolution for the first time. You are by now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are about to mouse click on that new Marvel Future Revolution app icon that was created. Your video game is launched for the first time. Now there we get it, I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the volume level of that emulator. It's right here, we have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the max, we should switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is the first one, we simply click on this particular software icon which I am showing in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Granted that we really want to have fun with the app in full screen, we select this particular icon. And we'd at present be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen setting. To exit the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And additionally we would likely at present play in regular display setting. At present, I am starting to demonstrate to you the keys mapping that is really rather interesting. That step we will certainly be capable to make use of the game application far more effortlessly. The first task is to click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will be able to get the appropriate configuration settings. Let me put the default settings, though if you like to modify that, you may very well do this without having problem. As you can observe, the emulator is totally in our language. On occasion it happens that your emulator is started in the wrong language, for instance, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to set it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And thus here inside of various other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can easily choose the language we wish, German, Chinese, and so on. When the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, as well as the video game, the next time we use it, would also be in the opted for language. So now, there's another element that we need to take into account, and it's that we will get an email reporting that a completely new device has been linked to our own Google account. It will definitely check with us if we're the ones who have associated with that device. Yes, we may not get worried, since the emulator is simulating a Google Android electronic device. So you can discover which electronic device is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And there we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that video tutorial. I anticipate you enjoyed it, specifically that you thought it was informative. If that's the case, offer it a nice thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer all your comments, requests or suggestions, leave them in the comment area below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every now and then, you have it down below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of these videos which are usually appearing on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the future online videos. Bye.